Let's go.
Tuning to the greatest show in Saudi. Jazz Zone. We're back on Chat Zone. NBC recently launched the NBC Academy. It is one of the most promising academies in the Middle East. It is the key indicator how NBC is improving the industry and investing to tomorrow's media scene and the entertainment. We are with the executive director, Jenna Yamani of the NBC Academy. Welcome to Chat Zone.
Thank you, Omar. Thank you for having me and looking forward to this interview.
NBC Academy has launched. What are the objectives of the Academy and what type of talents you're looking for?
So first off, let me give you just a quick overview on the objectives of the Academy. So what we want to focus on is building the next generation of content creators and media professionals that will take this industry in the country to the next level. With that, of course, يعني we want to look for models and methods of building Academy that is not traditionally focused. So we won't be focusing on different, I would say, degrees or majors and minors, but rather we want to be as agile and as practical as possible. So if we talk about the different programs that we have, we can look at it at three different pillars. We focus on inspiring and raising awareness, which is mostly focused on getting people excited about this industry, get the largest funnel of youth to say that I want to be part of it. So that's number one. Number two is once we get that excitement, then we move to the next stage of upskilling and training. And the training programs are mostly focused on taking someone's passion or experience, developing these skills practically and theoretically, and eventually take these talents and embed them across different projects within NBC and outside of NBC. The last stage, which is the most sustainable stage, is what would happen to the talents after you train them. You have to manage them. So it's a model in which we want to incubate these talents, have somewhat of a constant relationship with them, and also we work for their benefit. So we go and place them across different projects within NBC and outside of NBC and potentially in the world. The focus areas are quite wide. So we're looking at programs that focus on TV, film, theater, radio, podcasts, gaming, journalism, news. And of course, in skills that range from writing, creative writing, to sound and camera, and all the way to the acting and presenting on production and post-production. So this is the focus. Of course, over the next years, we will be growing on these programs and we'll add the ones that we think are relevant and are needed in the market.
Is there a specific background you're looking for, maybe with a specific degree to join the Academy with an experience?
Very good question. So we're looking at, I would say, two different segments of people or individuals we're looking for. The first segment are those that have been in the industry, quite seasoned. They're very experienced, potentially ones that got awards. So these are the ones that we want to go and expose them to more international projects. We manage them somehow. We place them in these big projects that we're doing within NBC and also exposures to interesting projects abroad that could also aim to change the mindset of what the region is all about globally. And we feel like that segment that could be very competitive globally is a very important one. On the other hand, we know that the industry is still, you know, very young and people are passionate, but they don't have the right tools to develop these skills. So we want to expose them to training, upskilling and whatnot. So the target where we're looking for there are the ones that just have the passion, potentially raw skills that we can bring in, fine tune, develop, and they don't have to have a lot of experience, but rather just the passion and the grit to be in that industry and work hard to prove themselves. So these two, in terms of age, we're looking for anyone above the age of 18, or from an acting perspective, anyone across all ages, because these are the ones that are lacking in the industry.
When it comes to NBC, NBC has always been the leader in the media scene, and the Academy is a big deal for shaping the talents with your leadership. Jenna Yamani, what is the roadmap for the Academy and Jenna Yamani?
So we're thinking of it in a short-term, medium-term, and long-term perspective. In the short-term, and I would say until the end of this year, we're focusing on three things. First of all, in the inspiration and raising awareness, we're developing these MBC Academy live sessions where we bring leaders from the region in this industry and influencers globally, like people from Hollywood or Asia that are that have been in this sector for quite some time, and we get them to engage with our youth, potentially answer questions that they have about what led them to the journey, to the end of the journey that they're in right now. So this is number one, and we're launching the first live session on Friday. Given the current situation, we're doing it all virtually until hopefully the situation permits next year where we do it physically. So this is number one. Number two, we're focusing on two different upskilling programs. The first one are on-set training. So we want first to start with ourselves in NBC. So we want to enable people to come and be part of the work that we're doing, be it with films that we're producing or TV shows or in productions or even in Shahid, our SVOD, and all the different needs in the company. Now, along with that, we know that for us to build these skills, we also have to do theoretical work with them. So we're doing workshops. Our first started this week, and it's focusing on the fundamentals of filmmaking with some Hollywood experts. We will continue doing these workshops over the next months, potentially introducing the next one to start in the fall and then later on by the winter. So these are the three focuses this year. Next year, we want to go and expand within our awareness campaigns that we want to do. We want to be on the ground. So we will do a road show across all the different regions in Saudi, potentially do some competitions with the different populations across these regions in filmmaking and theater and whatnot. And then in the upskilling programs, we want to go global. So we want to introduce scholarship programs for degree and non-degree programs. We want to build on that and enable the next generation filmmakers. So go and expose these feature films that they have globally in theaters and festivals outside of the region. And also build on the skills. So we will continually build on the skills, potentially do on-set training in studios and productions globally with our partners. And the last thing, we also want to work on the talent management. So at the end of the day, we want to build a talent management that could sustain and build on the talents that are envisioned for the next 3 years. We're seeing that this year, we have to find around 900 seasoned individuals to be able to deliver the work that we have planned for. Within 3 years, we have to have at least 5,000 in this industry. So we want to reach that level, hopefully, with all the programs we're doing, plus the talent management that we plan on even introducing.
I'm sure the listeners want to know about the registration. The registrations has closed, but there's some different availabilities. What are those availabilities?
So the registration closed for the filmmaking course, and the actual course just started this week. However, there's another program which is called On-Set Training. within MBC projects. These will be open, you know, ongoingly. So we will have it on a rolling basis. We will come and place individuals based on, of course, the skills that they have over the months, depending on the availabilities from the different productions we have. Additionally, after the completion of the course, the workshop that we introduced with the Hollywood experts, we will build on another one in the fall. So most probably registration is going to be open in the next 2 months for the second phase of programs. But on-set training will always be going and always open for people to apply for.
Jenna Yamani, thank you for being on Chat Zone.
Thank you very much, Arwa. Pleasure meeting you.
Chat Zone.
Hey, LeBron kind of mind state. Leave my iPhone on silent and vibrate.